Hi there. If we look into a recent article in the Retail Gazette in the UK, we notice that online fashion sales is now growing by annual rate this year in April, if you compare to last year, by 10%, which is the lowest growth rate in recent years. Now, this clearly is also observed in other countries such as France, Germany, where we clearly see that the domestic online market is still growing, but it's not growing as fast as it did in the past. So our observation is also that it makes a lot of sense to develop a cross-border strategy, not only into European countries, but maybe also beyond. But today we'll just focus on the European countries, the 27 EU countries. And there we clearly see that it poses certain challenges compared to doing business locally. We're still not the United States of Europe. We still have 27 countries in Europe with each its own legislation in terms of consumer protection and rules. Each country has its own VAT rules very often, own rules in terms of duties, etc. So we see that we also have the languages. We have all the different languages. So going cross-border is not it's not just an easy decision to make. It's something which has to be done cautiously and well-planned. However, we clearly think that it is something you have to do. You have to consider selling into more countries. We are today, most European consumers are used to buying online. So we believe there's a huge market out there if you put it in the right offer and the right solutions. My advice would clearly be to do this, as I said earlier, cautiously and well-planned, ideally initially on a country per country basis, starting in one country, testing your concept, seeing how it works in terms of your products working in that country, in that region, because every country, again, is also different in terms of behavior, which products are sold or bought most in some countries. Payment is clearly also a topic, maybe even an issue, in the sense that each country also has its own payment behavior. In some countries, it's very typical to pay, like Poland, to pay cash and deliver, cash on delivery, which is 60, 80%, 100% of all deliveries. Other countries are used to having payment 14 days or 1 week after the receipt of the parcel and the goods. So we have very different behaviors in each individual country. Now, what we believe again is our advice is to take it country by country, learn the habits, understand the behavior, also understand the delivery times. What are these countries expecting, the consumers in each country expecting in terms of delivery, etc. And we'll come back to that in a minute. As you probably also know, the EU Commission has decided to also help us stimulate cross-border sales, online sales in Europe. They're currently drafting a paper where they're asking a lot of players, whether it's e-tailers or service providers, to help draft this paper and to clearly identify the topics, the issues today, which are blocking cross-border sales in Europe. If we zoom in on Belgium, and we would like to use Belgium as an example because obviously it's a market we know well. If you look at Belgian market, we see that approximately 2.6-2.8% of retail sales is done online today. We believe it can double by 2015, so it's still very low numbers if you compare to other EU countries, and certainly to countries such as the UK, where we have much higher percentages, around 7-8%. In Belgium, if you look at Belgium, it's a small country, 11 million inhabitants, but we have three languages here, also different buying behaviors. We buy different products depending also on the region and the languages. It's clearly a good market for us to test going cross-border. We also have fairly developed, not to say very developed, internet connections. So we have a high number of broadband internet connections, which are definitely at the European level. But also additionally, we see that about 39% of online, people being online also buy online, so we are also, they're growing, and a person of 39% has purchased something online in the recent year. What is key in this discussion, and basically what we want to talk about today, is about 54% of these people buying something online have done that abroad. Why are they doing this? It's clearly because that, first of all, the offer we have in domestic market, for the domestic online market, is fairly limited. So people are very much used in Belgium to buy abroad, whether it's in Holland, in Germany, in France, still not as much from the UK. And we believe certainly that for the UK market, there's a big opportunity to go into the Belgian market and also sell your products into Belgium, because Belgians are used, as I said earlier, to buy online, but they're also not at all worried about purchasing products across the border. If you look at big companies such as Red Bull, P&G and others, they very often use Belgium as a test market. They basically say, well, if it'll work in Belgium, a complex market with three languages, within a fairly small market, they often test Belgium, they use Belgium as a test market to see if something works, and then they basically say, well, if it works in Belgium, it'll probably work anywhere in Belgium. So that's an additional reason also to think about using Belgium as one of your first countries going cross-border. So once you have decided to go cross-border with your products, so you've decided to sell your products in another country, then obviously the next discussion will be around distribution, delivery of your goods. How will you deliver your products to the end consumer in countries such as Belgium, but also other European countries? We know that delivery is a very integral and very important part of the whole buying process, the whole buying experience when you buy something online. What we have seen in the UK, but also in other studies, in recent studies, we have seen that when you sell cross-border, we have challenges such as 50-60% of shopping carts are abandoned before the consumer closes the sale. So he goes on your website, he buys the product, he selects the product, but he doesn't close off the final part in the checkout page. And we see a number of reasons for that. One reason is clearly that delivery is not always clearly explained. How does it work? What is the time frame? What is the cost of the delivery? What delivery options do you offer? Is it only home delivery? We know that home delivery in Europe is still the main, I would say, chosen delivery option, but you also have to other options, collection points. You have to deliver maybe into parcel machines if in that country it's a habit to receive your parcel in a parcel machine. So those are things you need clearly to look into. Returns. We don't want to talk about returns too much, but if you don't talk about returns at all, you may actually scare off your customer, because he may think that if there's something wrong with the product, or it's not the right color or the right size, that they cannot return it. So we also there strongly recommend to have a very clear policy on your website for your products on what to do about the returns. What are the roles and responsibilities? What is the cost of returning? What is the work the consumer has to do? What is the time frame that he can expect the reimbursement of his product? So all these things are absolutely key for a consumer when buying online, and even more when they buy cross-border. If you look at the current operators, we have seen studies in which 69% of UK consumers claim that they trust, for example, Royal Mail as a delivery partner. It's the same thing across Europe. In most countries, it's still very often the incumbent postal operator who is the most trusted to deliver and return parcels. Also, our networks are often very often known. Consumers know where the closest post office is. They know where to return a parcel, etc. So that's also a part of the offering which you clearly have to have in your website and when you want to sell abroad. If you look at the postal operators, they obviously today they can offer a very high quality service at a very reasonable price. But also important is that postal operators, they usually deliver every city, every street, every house, every day with mail products, so they can also deliver parcels. When you have decided to test the market, when you have done your homework on the selling your product and delivering your product, we feel it's very important that you look for a one-stop shopping solution when selecting your partner. You should really have a partner who offer a maximum of delivery options, potentially also deliver payment options such as cash on delivery if it seems to be important in that country. If you look at Belgium, cash on delivery is no longer very important. It used to be an important part of the payment process, but customers, consumers today are used to pay with credit card and bank cards. So once you have done all that, it's of course time to get started. And we again there recommend that you try to offer as many, basically you want to deliver or you want to lower the delivery barrier. If the consumer knows that, well, I can choose between home delivery, collection points, I have all the freedom to receive my parcel where and when I want, I can also easily return it. It's definitely one obstacle less that you have to overcome when going into a new country. So when you're ready for that, when you've done that, you can start testing how does a product work in that country, what are the delivery options, the payment options, etc. Then obviously you can start going into other countries. There we also recommend very often, once you have selected your partner, you should also have a partner who's not only strong in his own country, but can also help you rolling into other countries. And Belgium, for example, again, is a very well located country in Europe. We can easily operate as a hub into mainland Europe out of the UK. We know how postal operators work across the continent. So they also, operators can help you not only covering one country, but also helping you getting into other countries. I would say again, it's about you focusing on your core business. We are here, operators are there, not only us, but many operators are there to help you go into new markets, basically solving the logistics issues, but we can also probably help you do more. So again, in closing, I think what you need to think about are things such as, what about payment, what about delivery, what about returns, languages, etc. Although you can still get away, if certainly in countries like Belgium, but also in Holland, Germany, and maybe a little bit France, but certainly in these countries, you can even get away with only having a website in English. But we do recommend, once you go into more countries, you need to be able to serve those customers in their local language. Customer care is also an important part. Customers, consumers, they still want not only an email address where they can contact you, but ideally they should also be able to contact you by phone, at least during normal working hours, because we know that it's also a way of taking away that shopping barrier or the barrier to buy something online. So in closing, we wish you all the good luck in going online and launching into new countries outside the UK. And we will, of course, be happy to help you if you need more information about certain markets.